हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर ओन चैनल इंजीनियरिंग नेटवर्क। आई एम बैक विद अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द क्वांटिटी ऑफ सीमेंट, सैंड एंड एग्रीगेट इन अ फुटिंग। नाउ द फुटिंग दैट आई विल यूज इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो विल बी अ स्टेप्ड फुटिंग एंड आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन ईच स्टेप यूजिंग अ वेरी सिंपल एंड इजी मेथड। So if you want me to make a separate video on cost calculation of a stepped footing, then let me know in the comment section. So if you are having problems in finding the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate in a stepped footing, then watch this video till the end and I'm sure that it will definitely help you a lot. So if you find this video informative, then please like this video, share it, and if you are new to my channel, then please click on the subscribe button. And also don't forget to press the bell icon for more civil engineering videos. Okay, so in this video, I will be talking about how to calculate the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate in a stepped footing. Okay, so let's move forward. And as you can see, I have a stepped footing in which I will try to calculate the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate used in the construction of this particular stepped footing. Okay, so first let's talk about the dimensions. And here, as you can see, this stepped footing have basically four steps which are made of concrete. Now the first step that we normally provide in any type of footing is the plain cement concrete layer or PCC layer. And then we have got three more steps made of concrete. Now here remember one thing, that this is not an RCC stepped footing, okay, which means that I am not using any steel in the construction of this particular stepped footing. So the width of the PCC layer is 18 inches and height of the PCC layer is 6 inches. Then the width of the step 1 is 5 inches and the height is 9 inches, and after that the width of the step 2 is 12 inches and the height is also 9 inches, and the width of the step 3 is 9 inches and its height is also 12 inches. Okay, so now I have the height of each step, but here I don't have the total height of this stepped footing. So in order to find out the total height of this stepped footing, I will add the height of each step, and after adding these heights, the total height of this particular stepped footing will become 4.5 feet. Here also the length of this stepped footing is 15 feet. Okay, so if this stepped footing is used for the construction of a wall, let's say, then I can say that the length of that particular wall will be 15 feet. Now I am not saying that this particular stepped footing will be used in the construction of a wall. I mean it can be used in the construction of a building or a house as well. So here I am just giving you an idea that the length of this particular stepped footing is 15 feet. Here remember that for PCC layer I am using M15 grade of concrete. And for the remaining 3 steps, I am using M20 grade of concrete in their construction. Okay, so this is a simple and a brief description of a stepped footing. And now let's start calculating the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate for this particular stepped footing. So to calculate the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate used in this stepped footing, first I have to find out the wet volume of concrete for this particular stepped footing. Okay, so the wet volume of PCC layer will be equal to length into breadth into height. Here length of the footing is 15 feet, breadth or width of PCC layer is 18 inches which is equal to 1.5 feet. And height of the PCC layer is 6 inches which is equal to 0.5 feet. Okay, so the wet volume of PCC layer will be equal to 15 multiplied by 1.5 multiplied by 0.5, and after calculations it will become 11.25 cubic feet. So this is the wet volume of PCC layer. And after that I have to find out the wet volume for step 1. Okay, So the wet volume is equal to length into breadth into height. Here again length will be same as 15 feet. Width of step 1 is 15 inches, which is equal to 1.25 feet. And height of step 1 is 9 inches, which is equal to 0.75 feet. Okay. So the wet volume of step 1 will be equal to 15 multiplied by 1.5 multiplied by 0.75, and it will becomes 14.06 cubic feet. Next is the wet volume of step 2, which is equal to length into breadth into height. Here length is 15 feet, width of step 2 is 12 inches, which is equal to 1 feet, and height is 9 inches, which is equal to 0.75 feet. So after putting the values, the wet volume will be equal to 11.25 cubic feet. And similarly, the wet volume for step 3 will be equal to length into breadth into height. Here length is 15 feet, width or breadth of step 3 is 9 inches, which is equal to 0.75 feet. And height is 12 inches, which is equal to 1 feet. So after putting the values and doing little bit calculations, the wet volume of step 3 will becomes 11.25 cubic feet, right? So now I have the wet volumes of each step. And as I told you that I am using M15 grade for PCC layer and M20 grade for the remaining 3 steps. So because of the different grade of concrete that I am using, I will only add the wet volumes of the 3 steps, okay? So I am not adding the wet volume of PCC layer to it, because the grade of concrete used in the PCC layer is different. So the wet volume for PCC layer will be same as 11.25 cubic feet. And the total wet volume for the remaining 3 steps will be equal to 36.56 cubic feet, right? So now I have the wet volume for both PCC layer and for the 3 steps. And now in order to calculate the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate, I have to convert these wet volumes into the dry volumes, okay? And I have already uploaded a video on how to calculate the wet volume of concrete into the dry volume. So watch that video for better understanding. So let's first start with the dry volume of PCC layer. So the dry volume of PCC layer is equal to 1.54 multiplied by wet volume. Now here 1.54 is constant. And the wet volume of PCC layer is 11.25 cubic feet. So the dry volume of PCC layer will be equal to 1.54 multiplied by 11.25, and it will become 17.325 cubic feet. Next is the dry volume of 3 steps. So the dry volume for the remaining 3 steps is equal to 1.54 multiplied by the wet volume of the remaining 3 steps. Here the total wet volume of the 3 remaining steps is equal to 36.56 cubic feet. So the dry volume is equal to 1.54 multiplied by 36.56. And it will becomes 56.30 cubic feet. Okay. So now I am done with the dry volumes and now I am ready to finally calculate the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate for this particular stepped footing. So first let's start with the PCC layer. Okay. As I told you that in PCC layer I will use M15 grade of concrete. And we also know that the mix ratio of M15 grade is 1:2:4. So here in this mix ratio, 1 represents cement, 2 represents sand, and 4 represents coarse aggregate. So the sum of ratio is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 4, and it will be equal to 7. So the quantity of cement will be equal to ratio of cement multiply by dry volume of PCC layer and divide by sum of ratio. So here ratio for cement NM15 grade is 1. Dry volume of PCC layer is 17.325 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 7. Okay. So the quantity of cement is equal to 1 multiply by 17.325 divide by 7 and it will becomes 2.475 cubic feet. So to convert this 2.475 cubic feet of cement into the number of cement bags, I will simply divide it by 1.25 because the volume of one cement bag is 1.25 cubic feet. Okay. So the number of cement bags is equal to 2. Next is the quantity of sand. And for that I will use the same formula. So the ratio for sand in M15 grade of concrete is 2. The dry volume of PCC layer is 17.325 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 7. So the quantity of sand will be equal to 2 multiplied by 17.325 and divide by 7 and it will becomes 4.95 cubic feet. Next is the quantity of aggregate. So the quantity of aggregate is equal to ratio of aggregate multiplied by dry volume of PCC layer and divide by sum of ratio. So here ratio of aggregate in M15 grade of concrete is 4. The dry volume of PCC layer is 17.325 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 7. Okay. So the quantity of coarse aggregate is equal to 4 multiply by 17.325 divide by 7 and it will becomes 9.9 cubic feet. So this is all about the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate used in the construction of PCC layer for this particular stepped footing where I use M15 grade of concrete. Next is to calculate the quantity of material for the remaining 3 steps of concrete. And as I told you that in these 3 steps, I have used M20 grade of concrete. Okay. So we know that the mix ratio of M20 grade of concrete is 1:1.5:3. Here in this mix ratio, 1 represents cement, 1.5 represents sand, and 3 represents coarse aggregate. So the sum of ratio is equal to 1 plus 1.5 plus 3 and it is equal to 5.5. So the quantity of cement will be equal to ratio of cement multiplied by dry volume and divide by the sum of ratio. So here ratio for cement in M20 grade of concrete is 1. The dry volume of 3 steps is 56.30 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 5.5. Okay. So the quantity of cement is 1 multiplied by 56.30 divided by 5.5 and it will becomes 10.29 cubic feet. So now to convert this 10.29 cubic feet cement into the number of cement bags, I will simply divide it by 1.25 because as I told you before that the volume of one cement bag is 1.25 cubic feet. Okay. So the number of cement bags will be equal to 10.29 divided by 1.25 and it will be equal to 9 number of bags. Next is the quantity of sand and for that I will use the same formula. So the ratio of sand in M20 grade of concrete is 1.5. The dry volume of the remaining 3 steps is 56.30 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 5.5. So the quantity of sand will be equal to 1.5 multiplied by 56.30 divide by 5.5 and it will becomes 15.35 cubic feet. Next is the quantity of aggregate. So the quantity of aggregate is equal to ratio of aggregate multiply by the dry volume of the remaining three steps divided by the sum of ratio. So here the ratio for aggregate is 3 in M20 grade of concrete. The dry volume is 56.30 cubic feet and the sum of ratio is 5.5. Okay. So the quantity of aggregate is equal to 3 multiplied by 56.30 and divided by 5.5 and it will becomes 30.70 cubic feet. So this is all about the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate used in the three steps of a stepped footing for M20 grade of concrete. Now if I rearrange all these quantities, then the total number of cement bags required for this 15 feet long stepped footing is 2 plus 9 and it will be equal to 11 number of bags. The total quantity of cement is 20.3 cubic feet and the total quantity of coarse aggregate is equal to 40.6 cubic feet. So now I can say that for this 15 feet long stepped footing, I will need to have 11 number of cement bags, 20.3 cubic feet of sand and 40.6 cubic feet of coarse aggregate. So this is how you can easily find out the quantity of cement, sand and aggregate for a particular stepped footing. And it's very simple if you try it by yourself. Also share the results with me in the comment section for your footing quantities, okay? So if you find this video informative, then please like this video, share it. And if you are new to my channel, then please click on the subscribe button. And also don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will never miss a notification whenever I upload a new video. See you in the next video.